The F-100 Super Sabre was a revolutionary jet, the first U.S. Air Force fighter capable of supersonic speeds and level flight. But its design came with a deadly flaw, one that would claim the lives of multiple pilots. This flaw would become infamous under the name the Sabre Dance. The Sabre Dance was an aerodynamic phenomenon that plagued swept-wing aircraft. With the Super Sabre's highly swept wings and lack of trailing edge flaps, the aircraft required an unusually high landing speed. If a pilot allowed their speed to drop too low, the outer portions of the wings would stall. This caused the aircraft to pitch up violently, leading to uncontrollable oscillations, rocking from side to side in a deadly waltz with gravity. Attempts to correct the stall often made things worse. Even applying afterburner could send the aircraft tumbling into an unrecoverable state. The Sabre Dance was a known phenomenon amongst its pilots. Many pilots quickly learned that the only way to survive was to avoid the Sabre Dance entirely. But for Lieutenant Barty Ray Brooks, there would be no escape on this fateful day on the 10th of January, 1956. Lieutenant Brooks had only 674 total flight hours as a pilot and just 39 hours in the F-100. Barty Ray Brooks was born in Oklahoma in 1929 and later moved to Texas. A graduate of Texas A&M, he joined the Air Force through ROTC and became a jet pilot, eventually flying the F-84 and F-86 during his service in Korea. After the war, he became a ferry pilot, responsible for delivering newly built aircraft to operational bases. On January 10, 1956, Brooks and two other pilots picked up three brand new F-100C Super Sabres from the North American Aviation Factory in Palmdale, California. Their flight was short, just 42 miles to George Air Force Base, but upon lowering his landing gear, an issue was spotted with Brooks's nose wheel. The pivot pin securing the nose gear scissors link was missing. If he landed in that condition, his aircraft could have veered out of control. To increase his chances of survival, he diverted to Edwards Air Force Base, where a longer runway and emergency crews awaited. Please note that some parts of the video will cut to the original footage, which has no sound, mainly due to the fact that the input quality is too low. All the sounds in this video is designed by Warkive. This is not a field we excel at, so please leave any comments or tips in the comment section. A like and a subscription is also highly appreciated. Also note that the pilot flying here was killed. Although the images are not graphic, some viewers may find the following footage disturbing. Let's watch the Sabre Dance.